My name is Chalece DeLaCoudray. I'm a music technologist. A music technologist is somebody who thinks about the way that we engage with, the way that we create music, and pushes it towards the future by integrating advanced technology.
Hey.
Mike.
What's up, Chalece?
Chalece.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you.
My name is Mike Larson. I'm an audio engineer, and I've been in my profession for about 16 years. Started off as a kid just making records in his basement with his friends, producing and recording, and eventually turned that into a career. A couple years into working at different studios, having a few internships, I wound up meeting Pharrell Williams, and have been part of his team since 2008. The way Entrepreneur started was kind of like any other day in the studio. The goal of the track was to kind of sound vintage, like something that could have been made in like the 70s. It's been a crazy journey, and you know, I'm super thankful to be a part of everything that I have been.
Welcome students, welcome teachers. This is Your Voice is Power. Today we'll be covering layers of songs.
So let's dive into it.
Nice.
So what we've got going here is a Pro Tools session, mm-hmm. and this is the software that we use basically every day to record and mix all of the music that we work on. And the basic layout of Pro Tools, you've got all your tracks on the left side here, and I've got everything labeled, as you can see here, for each instrument. Your timeline is what we call the left to right view, and you've got, you know, minutes and seconds, and as well as bars and beats. So just a way to identify your position in the song and see where you're at. I've got everything grouped as far as my tracks. Every track in here is essentially a different instrument within the song.
Can you kind of dig into some of these individual stems and maybe talk about some of the different layers that are in the song?
Absolutely. So real quick, I'll run through the layers for this. First, we have kind of our strings layer, which is actually made up of a couple different string sounds, all playing the same melody. And this stays constant throughout the whole section, so this is really the bass of this whole part. More violins.
Ooh.
Just played a smoother kind of pattern. Back a little bit. So you can see how some of the sounds come in. There's a harp as well, which only happens twice in this part. Come in here.
That's nice.
And then we have our horns, which I'll solo real quick. So this horn stem is made up of, we have trombones, we have trumpets, we have flute, we have clarinet, mm-hmm. and saxophone.
Wow.
All playing together, so.
Ooh.
And the trumpet that comes at the end is really like the triumphant, like.
Coming through.
I've heard my buddy family describes it as he feels like you're driving on a mountaintop, like. And then at the end, you just go off the edge. But you're flying at that point.
Yeah.
And back to the drop, as we call it there, the verse music. And that's how the song ends.
Thank you for that tour of Pro Tools.
My pleasure.
Pro Tools is your playground. Now it's time to go to my playground. This is EarSketch, which is a program that lives on the internet. This is our code editor area. This is where all the magic happens. This is where we're gonna give EarSketch all of the instructions to place our sound clips and to set our tempo. Any instruction that we have musically, we're gonna type it in this code editor.
Okay.
EarSketch is designed for someone with absolutely no programming experience.
Wow,
whatsoever.
Okay, perfect. That's me. That's me.
So here's our code editor, our digital audio workstation, and of course we need sound clips, and those are all found over here in our sound editor area.
Got it.
Okay, so to get started, I'm just gonna load up a few clips. So we have a sound clip of the vocal sample. I'm gonna name it Arlen, after its own self. And I'm gonna put an equal sign, because in programming, equal is setting something, is like an assignment. Arlen,
right.
And say that is equal to this sound clip here. I can just copy it, and then it shows up here.
Oh, nice.
There's one more thing we have to do. We actually have to physically place the sound clip in the audio workstation. Okay. So we have to tell it to fit media, which is a function that we use.
Okay, what's a function?
A function is essentially a set of instructions that serves a specific purpose. When you create a function, you create it with a task in mind. Mm. So in EarSketch, we have fit media. That's a function that does a specific job. Fit media takes 4 pieces of information to do its job. It takes what sound you want, the track you want it on, the starting measure, and the beginning of the ending measure. So the sound that we want, we've nicknamed it Arlen, and then we place a comma. We want the track number to be 1 since it's our first sound, mm-hmm. comma. We'll start at measure 1 at the very beginning, comma, and then we'll do 8 measures, so we'll be ending at the beginning of measure 9.
Okay.
Right? So after we do that, we come over to this run button and run the instructions.
We should actually end it at 10 because the first bar is actually blank and there's just a snare on beat 4 of measure 1. So the real loop of the first 8 bars starts at bar 2.
Starts at measure 2. So let's do that. Start at measure 2 and then 2 plus 8 is 10. So we'll end at the beginning of measure 10.
There we go.
All right, so let's run those instructions. And then we've successfully, at the bottom, we have our console, and it tells us if anything is wrong or if everything is right. And at the bottom, we say script ran successfully, so that tells us everything is good. And up here in our audio workstation, we have at the beginning of measure 2, this Arlen Vox track.
Mm-hmm.
And we can set the metronome here so we can hear that and play the result. 2, 3, 4.
Sounds right.
Right. And it's really that simple. Now we go in and load up our sounds.
Cool.
We can do the same thing here with the bass guitar. If you're not sure what the sound is, you can just preview it here.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So I can say that's my bass 1 equals, copy this here. I'll just retype fit media. Bass 1 is my new sound. I'm gonna place it on track 2 this time as to not overlap the sounds.
Right.
And starts at measure 2, ends at measure 10. We can run our changes. And here's our second track. And push play.
Cool.
At this point, you really just build your layers. Build one on top of the other until you get every sound that you want.
Got it.
Now it's your turn to build whatever layers you like into your song.